Today, I'm going to show you how to give your React app AI superpowers, like being able to read data from your app, actually manipulating your app, getting AI suggestions in the chat, and even MCP support without building a complex backend. All of this is made possible because of a tool called CopilotKit that works with any React app or React-based framework like Next.js. Even if you've never built an AI feature before, the CopilotKit API makes the whole process so easy. In fact, let's go through a small example. And before we do, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. So here is the Vite React starter template. The styles here look a bit funny because I added the Tailwind import to my CSS, but the app should just work fine. Now, you have to use your imagination here for you to understand the potential of this. Imagine this is an analytics app or a travel booking site or an email client, something like that. Now, clicking down here will open my chat window and I can ask it anything like, what text is on this page? And wow, look at that. It gives me information about the text that's on this page from the header to the instructions, even to the count value of the click, which is already really cool. But I can ask it to do something else. Watch this. Change the count value to 23. Now just watch the count value. You can see it's changed it from 4 to 23. That is truly amazing. This model can control my app. I mean, imagine something like this automatically creating a Spotify playlist for you or automatically categorizing your emails. But that's not all. Watch this. What MCP tools do you have access to? Full disclaimer, I got an error the first time, so I had to refresh the page and start again. But we can see that this model has access to a bunch of GitHub-related tools, which is true because I gave it access to them through Composio. So not only can it read and manipulate data from your app, but it can also send the data to other platforms via MCP servers. Now that is seriously impressive. And I bet you're wondering how much it all costs. Well, it's completely free forever as long as you're self-hosting it, which is what I'm doing. So how did I add all this functionality to a simple React Vite site? Well, even though the CopilotKit API is easy to use, the whole process wasn't without its issues. Here, let me show you. So first I created a simple Express server with this middleware to act as a runtime endpoint, which simply means it handles requests from the front end to communicate with the LLMs. I then added my Anthropic API key and started the server on port 4000. But wait, what about all this MCP client code? I'll come back to that later. For the front end, which is just a Vite and React app, I created a chat interface component with a title, instructions for the LLM, and wrapped it around the app component. This also has the MCP server manager component, which simply connects to my Composio MCP server. And the main part of the app is wrapped inside a CopilotKit higher order component and connects to the backend using this URL. But after that, things started to get really interesting because the models themselves don't actually have any data by default. So I had to put all the text from the site in this object and added it to this hook so the LLM can read it. This also works for dynamic data too. Actions, on the other hand, are defined with this hook and can pretty much do anything you want. I mean, you can even use them to render UI elements in the chat. But things got a bit difficult for self-hosted MCP support, because for the cloud-hosted option, all you have to do is adjust the front-end. But for self-hosted, I had to do a lot of figuring out to try and set up an MCP server on the back-end. I first tried using the Model Context Protocol SDK, but I couldn't get it to match the type that CopilotKit expected. So I did a bit of digging in the source code and ended up using Vercel's AI package. Even though their Create MCP client is experimental, and I had to use this very specific transport configuration, which seems to work a lot better. But all that aside, I'm still really impressed with what CopilotKit has to offer. I mean, I didn't even go through setting up suggestions, predictive text areas, and persist chats through local storage. I would have loved to be able to add other models like DeepSeek or Llama via Light LLM, or been able to add MCP servers through the standard input-output transport mechanism and not just server-sent events. But hey, that's just me nitpicking. I think CopilotKit is truly something awesome, and if you want to add any AI features to your React app, you should honestly go and check it out right now.